When I got out of service in 45, I went to radio school out in California. And when I just about graduated, there was a bulletin on the board that said that Paul Jones was starting a station in Kennett, Missouri, and I immediately called him, and he offered me the job to come on out, and that's how I got started. Of course, I had lived in Kennett, you know, all those years before, and when I got out there, then there was Ray Vann and Johnny Mack, Bob Connors, and Mr. and Ms. Jones. I can remember a young lady there in the office, Bernice. Ray Vann had gotten it on the air first, and Johnny Mack, with Bob Connors. And I came in right after it started. So they were already on the air when I came in.
Were you just working as an announcer, or did you have other duties?
As an announcer, I helped kind of schedule things, but not too much. That was left up to Ray, and I can't remember now whether, I don't believe there was anybody else in there at the time. And I started out just announcing.
What name did you use on the air, Ray?
I used Norman Shane, S-H-A-I-N. I dropped the bird, made it sound easier to remember. And that's the way most of the people around there remember me now, or at that time. Of course, like I say, we had lived in Kennett prior to that and naturally knew a lot of people. I did news, did music programs, and of course at that time we had live entertainment, and I can remember a family coming in with a bunch of young barefooted boys, girls that called the Wilburn family, and it happened that they went on to make it big in the country and western field. Yes, sir, they came in and auditioned, and they were very good for their age, all youngsters, and they did a marvelous job, and they went on from there to make it big. The early part of 48, I moved from KBOA down to Memphis to a station. Before that, a young lady came in to work at KBOA from Hayti, and she came over to do a Red Cross program, and Ray Vann hired her to write scripts and advertising. And it wound up that she eventually came to Memphis, and we got married. Her name was Peggy Gilbert. And we went on from there, like I say, to Memphis, and then to California. Peggy worked at KFI NBC TV station in Los Angeles. And after that, we came back to Missouri to a station and stayed there until about, 52. And we both got out of radio then.